This is the Hartnell Governor. It is spring-loaded governor. Now, this is the casing of the governor. This spring is loaded here with the casing, upper portion of the casing is loaded spring with spring stiffness is there. Stiffness is nothing but force per unit deflection, Newton per meter. So generally this ball, there are two balls, and this is the distance, this is the fulcrum. The distance between this one is A, and this is the centrifugal force, and this is the force W plus S by 2. Because when the spring is going upward, it is compressed and it will give a force in the downward direction. That will be S. So it will add to the slip weight plus S divided by 2 in the left half. Okay, now this is the collar, and this is the V, this is the slip. Slip moves up and down with RPM. If RPM is increased, it goes up, and if it is decreased, it comes down. Now, this type of governor consists of a casing A fixed to the spindle. This is the spindle. Fixed to the spindle and rotates with it. A compressed spring is placed inside the casing, which presses against the top of the casing on an adjustable collar. C. Collar is the C. The slip V, this is the slip V. The slip V can move up and down on the vertical spindle depending upon the speed of the governor. This is governor. Governor balls are carried on bell crank levers, which are pivoted on the lower end of the casing. The balls will fly outwards as the speed of the governor shaft increases. Now, this, you please note down the figure, draw the figure correctly, and this is the slip plus spring force by 2, and this is the centrifugal force F, and this is the fulcrum. So W is equal to the weight of the slip with if total weight of the slip. Small w as it is weight of the of each ball. This is the force exerted. The force exerted by the spring. All these are Newton. The spring stiffness is P is denoted here because in governor, if I write down K, which is usually denoted, which is usually denoted, denotes the stiffness, but I have written P for governor here. P is the stiffness of the spring. R is the radius of the rotation. A is the length of the vertical arm, means this one. This is A, and this is the B, the lower arm. B is the length of the horizontal arm. R1 is the maximum radius, R2 is the minimum radius, and X is the total movement of the slip. Now, I will tell you this figure R1 and R2. This is the maximum position of the ball. Now, this is the axis of rotation. This one is R1, maximum, from here to here. And R2, when the force is minimum, this is when the speed is minimum, then this point to this point is R2. Okay? So, I repeat, R1 minus R2 will be equal to A theta when theta is very small. S is equal to R theta in general. Then when the upper arm mass is outward, then this will be here. And when it is in the minimum position, the lower arm will be here. So this is also angle theta. We assume this angle and this angle will be equal actually at the fulcrum. So X is equal to B theta. Okay. Next, we are taking moments of about the fulcrum of the bell crank lever and ignoring, this is most important, ignoring the effect of the pull of gravity on the governor balls, means W is neglected, is zero, and lever arms. W of the lever arms. We are taking moment about fulcrum. O, F into A will be equal to W plus S by 2 into B. That I have already shown you. This is anticlockwise F into A. And this one is clockwise. W plus S by 2 into B. So we have this is anticlockwise moment will be equal to the clockwise moment. Or anticlockwise moment minus clockwise moment is equal to zero. Same thing. F into A is equal to W by S by 2 into B. W plus S by 2 into B. This is the equation. From there, this is the equation. And this is the equation, general equation of spring force related to the centrifugal force with the weight of the slim. Now, if for the maximum it is S1 and if for the minimum it is S2, AB remains the same, F will already change, F will change. So, for maximum and minimum, S1 is for maximum and S2 for minimum. So, W plus S1 will be equal to 2 into A by B into F1. W plus S2 is equal to 2 into A by B into F2. This is the equation 1. You subtract this one, W will cancel out. Capital W will cancel out. S1 minus S2 will be equal to 2 into A by B into F1 minus F2. I have already told you X is equal to B theta. X is the total lift of the slim. X is equal to B theta, and also R1 minus R2 is equal to A theta, where theta is very small. So X by B will be equal to R1 minus R2 by A. Yes, no? Theta will be equal to X by B, and theta is equal to R1 minus R2 by A. So these two will be equal. So X by B will be equal to R1 minus R2 by A. So from here, X can be found out. X will be equal to B by A into R1 minus R2. Okay? Is it okay? Is it okay? S1 minus S2 will be equal to 2 into A by B into F1 minus F2. Okay? Now, is equal to the stiffness, spring constant, P, small p, into X. And from here, we can find out P is equal to 2 by X. Small p, spring constant, is equal to 2 by X, is the total lift, A by B, bracket, into F1 minus F2. Is equal to 2 into A by B, a whole square, into F1 minus F2 by R1 minus R2. Because X is substituted. This value of X is substituted here. So that we get this one. So the spring constant can be found out from this equation. 2 into A by B whole square minus F1 minus F2 bracket by R1 minus R2. So F1 minus F2 by R1 minus R2. Okay? So for any intermediate position, say R radius, the centrifugal force F can be found out from P is equal to 2 into A by B whole square. This is there. And 2 A by B whole square into F minus F2 by R minus R2. We replace this F1 by F and R1 by R. So we can have the same equation because spring constant is a constant for a particular setup. So from these two equations, this and this cancels out. So this by this will be equal to this by this. So F1 minus F2 by R1 minus R2 will be equal to F minus F2 by R minus R2. So here R1, R2, R, F2, F1 are known. So this F can be found out from this equation. Thank you.